Customers were already on the progression to zero trust, and then the pandemic hit, and it became a necessity. From the hardware to the firmware to the software, chip to cloud, customers need to find a way to not only manage, but secure the device going to all of their employees. This became a hard requirement as security attacks have picked up across the entire stack. In fact, even firmware attacks have increased by 5x recently. I'm really excited to walk you through the possibilities with Surface and Autopilot to give you both security and management from a remote zero trust way. Next on the Solution Show with Corey. Hi there and welcome to another Solution Show with Corey. I'm so excited to be talking about actually really important topic here with Mark Hodge. Mark, can you first start off by introducing yourself and sort of the team and the stuff you work on, and then we'll get straight into the problem that you're solving.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first, thanks, Corey, for having me on the show. Well, my name is Mark Hodge. I support the Surface Hardware Division inside Microsoft with the title of Global Black Belt. That just means that I get involved in some complicated stuff and take a broader view of Microsoft and everything we have to bring to bear.
Look, you know, this has been a really tough time for the last couple of years for a lot of our customers in figuring out how to make sure that they can remain secure, remain safe, even with so many employees working remotely. Walk us through a little bit about the problems that customers are facing here and sort of the approach that we've taken.
Yeah, absolutely. So yeah, the pandemic really highlighted the power of modern management and security, especially when it comes to business continuity. And even before the pandemic, right, we were on this massive trend around digital transformation, moving to cloud and work from anywhere. And if you think about it, another way to say that is an organization's footprint was going outside the four walls of the organization. And so this has caused the security model that everybody has been using to evolve from a perimeter-based security model to a zero-trust security model. And then, bam, the pandemic hit, right? And then no matter where you were on that trajectory, you found yourself with all your non-essential workers remote, whether you're ready or not. But we had one customer, it was a school district that decided to go with Surface Go for all their K-12 students. They allowed all the students to keep the device over the summer. No need to risk the students to bring it back in. Anyway, when the school recommenced, none of the devices could connect to the network. Ooh. That's a big problem. And none of the students had admin privileges to make self-changes and fix the problem. Well, this customer was in the process of migrating from an on-prem third-party device management to Microsoft Endpoint Manager in the cloud. So the devices managed by Microsoft Endpoint Manager, IT pros went in, made a couple changes, it flowed down, fixed those devices in short order, back in business. For the remainder of the devices, it was a challenge and there was no easy solution. But at the end of the day, they had to request the students come in during the pandemic, plug the device into the school network just to recover.
I'd love to understand a little bit your perspective on sort of what modern management means to Surface and how we approach that from a device perspective.
Yeah, so let's take a little closer look and see how Surface was built for modern management and specifically around Autopilot, which is Microsoft's zero-touch deployment service found in M365. Hey, when customers are clamoring for Surface devices, they can place an order with our partners or resellers, and those resellers will upload the list of devices into our Autopilot service, which then gets synced into the customer's tenant. All while that's happening, the device can be shipped directly to the end user. They get the joy of taking the shrink wrap off the device and being the very first to touch it. This is a very different process than what's traditionally happens. You get a new device, it gets shipped into the four walls of the organization, you have a golden image, you wipe and replace. That golden image now happens up in the cloud, and we don't do golden images anymore, we do profiles. So when this end user opens the box, powers it on, connects it to the network, it goes through a zero-touch provisioning process driven by the corporate login. And so everything the IT pro has configured, whether it's device configuration, security policies, apps, certificates, everything it will flow down to the device and it will convert that box fresh out, or the device fresh out of the box, to a enterprise grade corporate device ready for business and making the employee as productive as possible. Once it's usable, then we can use the same framework of modern management and tooling to administer the device, and we can start talking about lifecycle manages a management of deprovisioning and warranty. Unique to Surface, the Surface is the only OEM that can do a device deregistration from the Autopilot service during a warranty replacement. Now, if I pivot here from deprovisioning to security, you can see that regardless of what the IT Pro policy is sent down to this device, Microsoft at the factory sets a whole bunch of security parameters to lock down the Surface before it even comes out of the box. This is around virtual-based security, HVCI, which is hypervisor code integrity. Yeah, it's a mouthful, but it's super important when it comes to security of the device before it even comes out of the box. We know the threat landscape is changing a lot. Microsoft just produced a security report in March claiming that firmware attacks are up by 5x, and 83% of respondents say that they have experienced a firmware attack in the last 2 years. We're very familiar with Surface and its unique form factor. Surface Pro, the 2-in-1 form factor, Surface Hub, large screen, et cetera. But that's all visible. When we start talking about UEFI, which is a type of firmware that runs underneath the operating system, Microsoft about 6 years ago decided we're not going to outsource that and use third-party vendors. We're going to write this ourselves so that we can bring the best security to it. And this allows us to have the UEFI participate in the Windows Autopilot service. And it brings a new level of security. And this is not something we're doing secretly. This is an open source project. It's called Project Mu. We want open and transparency to this, and we want to be thought leaders in the security market. We want people to copy us on this because we think it's the best security for PCs on the market.
You know, I think you actually had some examples to show us here in a demo. I'd love to sort of see some of the options that actually can be deployed this way.
Yeah, so let's jump into the web portal, and I'll show you a couple knobs that you can do when you're configuring this
awesome.
In Endpoint Manager. Here we find ourselves in the Microsoft Endpoint Manager. I've already gone to the DFCI or Device Firmware Configuration Interface, and these are the controls that we have to lock down the firmware of the device. And so we can lock it down so the end user can't use these or go change them themselves afterwards, which is pretty important if we want to lock it down. You can lock down camera, microphone, and radios. Radio is super important in highly secure areas like in the federal government or maybe healthcare. A camera in the federal government, they often drill out the camera because it's not allowed in there and fill it with epoxy. Being able to disable it in this DFCI configuration removes power from the camera, so the operating system doesn't even see it, and it's all locked down with certificates, so it can't be turned on unless you have that certificate. With boot options, we have an interesting aspect about boot from external media. So I already talked about schools, and the school district had the students keep the device all summer. Well, if you have an enterprising young student, they may try and re-image a device with Linux or some other operating system, and that may not be what you want. And so you can lock that down too. And from a corporate perspective, combining Autopilot with this DFCI lockdown, it means if somebody steals your laptop, Corey, they can't image it. It is going to be locked to the tenant, and it is basically a doorstop. And so there's a lot of security aspects all rolled in when you combine Autopilot with DFCI.
Thanks so much, Mark. It's what an awesome demo to show us. And it's just so exciting to be able to see sort of the layering of both the management and the security down at the hardware, including the firmware and controls at the firmware level, like the camera being able to be powered off as part of this, all the way up to the management stack, and all of this being able to be remotely delivered such that we can truly enable this age of zero trust. without requiring some pretty crazy things like shipping in your laptop or bringing it back to the office during during this very difficult pandemic. So it's just so exciting to see what's built into Surface and enabled through this autopilot capability to truly support the end-to-end security and management of our customers. So thank you so much for showing us this and really exposing this great capability.
Yeah, thanks. My pleasure.